and welcome to Goggle and
Squeak.
Squeak. Goggle and Squeak beer reviews. me, Terry Kay, Mr. Beer Goggles, and Mrs. Beer Goggles.
Hello.
Hello, she says. Let's see if you can get a word in edgeways this time. You have to jump in, you know what I'm like.
Bad chance.
Don't call me that. It's Mr. Fat Chance to you, isn't it? Right. Stop pulling faces at me. I can see you. Right.
They can't.
I'm going to get the old BB Barfly and open up a very nice and special one. And the missus, she had one of the Trappist beers before. She loved it because it was sweet. It was like a liquor. Like a liquor it was. Like a liqueur.
Ew.
And she liked it.
Nice.
So this one is, what percentage are we talking? I've got to get the magnifying glass. 6.2, so it's not very high.
I know.
But it's, yes, kind of. This is one of the Trappist beers, this is Orval. I wish I could fly, way up to the sky, but I can't.
You can.
I can't.
You can.
What was it? I ate that duck.
Let's do a bit deeper.
Isn't it? I'm wiping the glasses on my shirt, by the way.
Oh, lovely.
Glass myself up, really, you know.
Or glass yourself up.
Glass myself up, even. No, I'll glass you up later. When you haven't got me about. Isn't it? I've got a pint glass. And a little bottle. And another little glass for the missus. Because I don't want to share her germs and things and all that, you know, all she gets her tongue down the bottom of
her. I don't want your beard fluff in it, thank you.
All the food out of my beer. Boy, there's a lot of...
beard.
There's a lot of jumped out the top of that. I don't think you can see that. Where are we? There. See all the kind of like pouring the stuff. Anyway, I'm pouring it and this might be bottle conditioned, so... I'm going to carry on pouring it. I've got to do a very clever one here and pour two of them without pouring it back on itself in case you've got sediment or sedative. I'll give you a little one there. Right.
Thank you very much.
I'm changing them over quick.
Because I'm a lady.
She's a lady. Let's have a look. I can't see any... I hate these bloody brown bottles. You can't see nothing, but I can't see any sedative at all in the bottom.
No cement in it,
no? No cement or sedative, so I'm just going to pour that in a bit wildly. See if, nope, crystal, darling, you got it crystal. Right.
Get it start on the Smurf.
On the Smurf? You're getting an head start on the Smurf, did you say?
Yeah, I might have a winning chance on the Smurf.
Yeah.
About the same, right?
Is that that gold Smurf and Frankenstein?
Isn't it?
That's a proper Christmas one, that is. I might have poured the tiniest bit of yeast, you know, I don't know. It's hard to tell. I don't read up before I do these, so, you know, if they're whether they're bottle conditioned or not, I don't read up because I find you get taste notes and things like that, and I don't like to know about taste notes. You know, so there is a slight murkiness there, and now I've poured the lot in, so it might have had a very slight, bit of bottle conditioning in the bottom. But it's yours, I think, is crystal, is it? Yours? No, there's a slight murkiness, smurf in there. Slight murkiness to that as well.
Smurf now, am I?
But it's nothing wrong with that. It brings all the flavours in.
Oh,
right, give it a little twirl, missus, and have a sniff.
When you first poured it in, there was loads of fragrance coming out of it.
Mmm, smells nice. It's got a kind of slight floral note in the background, but it's a lot of...
There's a lot going on the smells, but
yeah, there's currants, biscuits, you know, like Gary Baldy's.
Mm.
When you break him open. Don't call me back Gary Baldy. What's the matter with you? I know what you're thinking when I said it.
Gary Baldy.
Bitch.
You love it.
Isn't it? I hope your tits fall off.
Throw them at you if they do.
Isn't it? Lovely. I'll be like a man in a ball, a kid in a ball pit. No, we're not ball pit, not ones like that. Reminds me when them play pins. What do they call them? Ball pits things.
Exactly that.
A ball pit.
A ball pool.
Ball pool. It's not a ball pit. That's where they do ball fighting, isn't it?
No, they call them ball pits as well. Ball pit, ball pool.
Is it?
All same thing.
Oh, that's what I'd be like. Mind you, know my luck, I'd fall into a ball pit full of boobs and I'd come out sucking my thumb. That's my luck, isn't it? You know, stop it, I'm sorry.
You're better off.
This is a serious reviews. Come on, it's serious. We're tasting Orval now.
We're fluffy thing. Yeah. I thought you said it had Smurfs in
the break. We're having a fluffy duck.
God, they're sickly.
Good job I didn't say that with a spoonerism, wouldn't it?
Isn't it?
She don't even know what spoonerism is. She thinks you feed yourself.
How dare you?
Isn't it?
How dare you? Isn't it? You won't take it off camera, I'm going to get
the what else are you getting in there? You're getting...
It's almost like a dark chocolate in there somewhere.
Yeah.
Really dark chocolate.
I wouldn't say really dark, it's not like
70-80% chocolate.
No, I'm getting a bit less, I'm getting a bit smoother, a bit creamier. Yeah. You're getting a kind of a tangerine note in there as well. Clementine sort of tangerine.
Kind of reminds you of Christmas.
Yeah.
Kind of a Christmas.
But you've got clementine, tangerine. Yeah. You're getting slight mulled wine things, I think.
Yeah.
It reminds you of Christmas and also almost a Christmas pudding, but not quite that strong.
No, it's with tangerine and chocolate. Yeah. The mulled wine.
Yeah, and the cloves in. You know when you get the cloves in the orange and fry them in there.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's say chin chin. Cheers, chin chin. Bottoms up, folks.
Sound like
three
little pigs.
Up your bottoms and everything. Tastes more watery than I was expecting.
Yeah, I was expecting it to be a bit thicker.
Yeah, like me. sharp. Now, it tastes more watery than I was expecting, and not quite as nice as I was expecting. It tastes very light.
Kind of reminds me of a red wine,
slight tannins in there, yeah. It's slight tannins. I don't think there'd be kind of... it's not got the depth of a red wine in it, though.
No, it's just what it reminds me of.
Now, I'm expecting, when I buy something like that, I'm expecting that to be a little bit extraordinary, a little bit extra. I don't know about you, babe, right? But to me, it tastes kind of a bit average.
Yeah, it's another middle-of-the-road job.
Yeah, seriously.
It's nice.
I've been a little bit disappointed in beers tonight.
It's my fault.
Yeah. It is nice. It's nice, but it's a very kind of subtle middle of the road nice. It's not kind of doing anything. And when you're expecting these beers like this to kind of be really punching their weight, really kind of like big expressive beers, isn't it? You ain't saying much.
It's wording edgeways again.
See, I leave empty air and then I just go...
That's not empty air when you go like that, because you won't stop talking.
But when I breathe in, that's when you have to attack.
Kind of that quick. I get the rolling pin.
So what's your opinion on this? You know, give us your opinion.
It's very nice, but it's not something I would kind of be highly recommending. It's not like,
yeah,
go out and buy this,
it's
fantastic, you know.
Yeah, it's nice, but these are a little bit dearer than most beers.
Yeah, it's not one you kind of go, look, special.
And I kind of think that you're buying a name with this one. If I mean, I'd imagine, I haven't tried any of the other Orval beers. It's not awful, Orval. I haven't tried any of the other Orval beers, but...
Do you know what the taste lets the smell down? Because the smell smells really rich and...
Yeah, it smells all sorts of loveliness.
Yeah, and then you taste it and it's kind of like...
Other way around. Sometimes you smell beers and you go, not getting nothing here. And you taste it and there's an explosion going on. Mm. You know?
It's kind of the other way around with this one. It's like all on the nose and then you drink it and it's like...
Yeah. It lets you down a little bit.
Where's it gone? Where's the taste? Where's the flavours gone?
Yeah. I mean, I'd still say try and buy it.
Yeah, it's an all-rounder. It's
but nice. The price, if it's the right price, and usually these ain't in the supermarkets, and the kind of the price is You're talking a little bit dearer on that because they've got like the Trappist thing on the back or wherever it is. Is it? Here it is, like on there, that little tiny thing there is a Trappist sign. I don't know if you're getting that. Yeah. But yeah, you got a little Trappist thing on there, so it's kind of bona fide in everything. But I think you're kind of paying for that where for the same price and ordering it at the same kind of online shops and that you'd order that in, you could have 1,000 other better beers. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
If you went and ordered it somewhere like Beers of Europe, you've got God knows how many thousand beers in there. You know, and you go and get this one out and you're thinking, I could have got... I had to walk past 1,000 different beers that would have been better than that. And I ended up leaving them because I wanted that one, you know. So you'd walk past 1,000 other better beers than that, and it kind of lets you down a little bit in that direction, I think. Speak, it's your turn.
I haven't got that experience to agree with you there, hon, but I can understand what you're
but
saying.
But you know what I mean, you know.
I do understand what you're saying, yeah.
Yeah.
You're going after the name brand that you
so
trust.
So speaking as a pleb, what would you kind of say then?
I don't know, Don, I'd have to leave that to you.
So you won't get off the missus.
You're the expert in that department.
Right. So this is me, Mr. Pleb, speaking to you. From the grave soon.
Yes, I'm getting the rolling pin as we speak.
I'm in trouble.
Yes.
Anyway, missus.
Yes.
Sign off and speak to him and everything. Tell him how horrible I am.
He's lovely.
I'm lovely.
Very lovely.
Anyway, what do I look like through the lens? Let's have a look.
What?
Oh. Hello. Sorry, I don't know what I'm doing. It's been me, Terry K, for Beer Goggles Reviews, and...
Mrs. Beer Goggles
Reviews. Mrs. Beer Goggles Reviews.
Squeak!
Cheerio, chin chin, squeak, squeak!